Marlon, heads up.
Yes, ma'am. Wow, that is a big diamond there. That's a lot of love. I couldn't love anybody like that.
Oh, yeah,
that's
you
a
can.
Lot of love. Not right now. Wow, that's big. You sitting around like this. Oh, my husband loved me.
Oh, you've got some diamonds in your ears there.
Hey, ain't as big as that. This is a piece of salt compared to that.
Hey, I want to congratulate you on a very funny movie.
Thank you very much.
Very funny.
Thank you.
Yes, and you're just unbelievable.
Well, thank you.
I was so impressed with your performance because it just, it has everything. It has sight gags, it has physical comedy, it just has everything.
Well, thank you. Thank you.
Does physical comedy come easy for you?
Yeah, but no, not as easy as I used to think. When I was younger, it was easier. But as you get older, you know, the bones start hurting and you realize, you know, you fall and stuff hurts, you know. But it's a lot more work now, but it's still a lot of fun. And my director, Penelope, I always got to give her her credit. She did a really wonderful job of telling the story and helping to direct the physical comedy and keeping the story grounded as well. It was important.
You do so many different jobs in this, one funnier than the next. In real life, have you ever had any funny odd jobs?
Oh, man. Yeah.
Like what?
What I do, man, I used to collect bottles and cans. Me and Sean, we had our own little bottle and can business. And this is like when I was about, from like the ages of like 8 to 13, we used to get like 5 cent refills. But then my brother Sean, like, went to high school and he got cool and I was still collecting bottles and he'd be outside talking to girls and I'd show up with a big bag of bottles to my Sean, I got the cans, and he'd be like, you know, make believe he didn't even know me, like, I'm talking to her, honey. This whole, and he tried to play it on the hall, this, that, I don't know him, he's just a homeless kid. But then when he got home, he'd take half the money, I'll tell you that much.
Where would you go, along the freeways, or where was the best place?
Hey, with those bottles, I'd be in your house. You look, and all you see is some feet sticking out of your trash can. Oh, I'm sorry. He's grabbing this can, Coke can.
And because you were the youngest of the Wayans boys, did you take a lot of flack from the older guys?
Of course. In our family, coming from a family of comedians, you're not considered the youngest, you're considered the victim, you know? So I got out, because they could do all kinds of stuff to me and I can't beat them, so what am I to do except take the punishment? But actually it makes me it gives me a certain edge, you know? I'm able to take a good joke, which is important.
Did you learn from them as far as your craft?
I learned a lot from them. It's weird because I grew up in the house of my idol. You know, I used to idolize, and I still do, my brothers. Them, Richard Pryor, Eddie Murphy, Jerry Lewis, those are my, like, idols. And my brothers, all of them, like my mom and dad. You know, I definitely found it inspiration. You know, my brother Keenan, to see him go out to California and make his dream a reality was important, because it was like, I didn't have to dream of it. I can actually do this and actually be successful at it? And then Damon went out there and, you know, he did it. And we was like, damn, Keenan's not a fluke. Let's go make it happen.
If your last name is Wayans, you got it made.
Yeah,
huh?
There you go. Or Wayne, anything close. Wayright, Wang. No matter.
Your first name, Marlon. Are you named for Marlon Brando?
No, actually I was named after Marlon Jackson.
Ah.
Our family is a big Jackson family fans. And they wanted to name me after Michael, but then my sister's, my mom wanted to name me after somebody black, so they named me after Marlon instead. I'm joking.
You know what I told you when I came in here? I'm French, Irish, and Texan.
I know, you'll kick my butt, I'm sorry. No, but actually, I really was going to be named Michael, but Michael was too much of a comedy. We really did like the Jackson. I'd be mad if they named me. Toya.
That would serve her well.
Yeah. Yeah, it did.
I wanted to ask you also that, you know, you're making some money now. So the first big money that you ever made, what did you buy for yourself?
Nothing. You would always be mine.
Why not?
I buy it really cool. That's all I ask for. I don't buy a lot of jewelry. Because I feel like my money, I want to put it away. And I want my kids to enjoy my money. When I have children, I want them to enjoy it. And I want my family to enjoy it. So the first big thing I bought was my sister's car. And all my sister's car. And that was the best feeling I had in the world. Buying my mom a car was just like, okay.
What does she do with it?
She looks at it. Oh, this is my car.
Then she go hop on the bus. She park it right next to the bus station. This is my car.
What kind of car is it?
A Lincoln Town car.
Well, I can see why she doesn't want to drive it.
But, I mean, she don't have a license.
Oh, okay.
My mom just, you know, she's like one of the women that just like to have things, just to say, look at this. You know, it's like, we bought her some diamonds. She wouldn't wear them. She'd keep them on the side and go, and then put them right back in the box. Like, maybe sport them to church or somewhere where she could flaunt them. But, you know, my mom was just funny.
Marlon, you're a trip. You're really fun. And wonderful. That is so fun. I got them. And I look forward to the next time we can sit here and talk. Like your mama, whatever.
Pleasure.